It's usually for my eyes only. I know just this once you have to see it, but I want you to pretend you're not.
So this was Ares's humble abode for 13 months. Very humble. A lick of paint on the walls, a couple of throw rugs would have killed him.
You were the one who ordered revenge on the giants, remember?
Hey, they made a move on my wife. I don't share.
She sure does.
Is this...
Oh, yeah. Aphrodite's magic girdle. Jealous?
Should I be touching this? I wouldn't want to set it off.
Relax. It has to be worn to trigger its magical desire. Now stop squirming and bring it back. And remember, you never saw it.
Right away. I mean, so what? Huh? Oh! Hey, Ares! A little help!
Prepare to be shaken, not stirred!
Whoa! I can't believe you spent over a year in there. My back's all cramped.
The panic never leaves me. Now, where is it?
Aphrodite's girdle? Right here. It suits you. Sometimes it's better to make love, not war.
If I admit you're right, never tell anyone anything about this.
You have my word.
You're right. Now it's time to play Switch the Girdles with Aphrodite. I wonder how many bruises I'll get this time.
You say that like it's a good thing. Oh, got it. Enjoy. You did this looking for the clue, didn't you, Phosphor? No. The hollowed-out beauty of violence is a gilded handle set upon the knife's blade. I heard that once. These people's poor houses. You may think I'm weak, but at least I try to live for something more than my own pride. Can you say the same? A clue! Where wild bears roam, King Cocolis's riches lie cold, waiting to be woven into temples and gardens, warmed by the blood of my heart and the fiery springs of my tears. Speak aloud, my beloved, as you turn the key, and you may enter my treasure room. Hmm.
After killing the Spartoi soldier for Ares, Fenyx found a piece of broken armor. She would have to find its other half.
Lucky Fenyx! Exacting vengeance! It's my favorite hobby.
Hmm.
after looting the other piece of armor, Fenyx discovered it wasn't in good shape.
Not like there's a whole land dedicated to forges or anything.
My love.
Speak, my queen.
Are you all gone again?
Not a feather remains.
Oh.
What is it?
Even, you know.
I killed the Spartoi soldiers like you asked. Consider yourself vengeanced.
Ah, excellent. I mean, excellent. I was a chicken for too long. Oh, the nightmares.
The battle armor on them was all banged up.
I hate to admit it, but Hephaestus's forge on the northeast side of the island could fix it up.
Was that a compliment? You have changed for the better.
But watch out for the idiot in charge.
I stand corrected.
A good warrior needs great armor. Swords don't mess around.
What?
Poor Helen. Once Eros struck her with his arrow, she was powerless to do anything but leave her husband, Menelaus of Sparta, for Paris.
This jewel is huge, but it's been broken. I wonder where the other pieces are.
Ugh.
What Fenyx couldn't know was that Hephaestus' future gift to Harmonia was cursed.
Hephaestus learned that move from his mother.
Monster defeated and reward given. This wrapped up nicely, no?
I want to know more about this prophecy of the cursed gift. Who's Harmonia?
A child of love and war.
Ah, more meaningless poetry.
If you say so.
No more fearing the future! No more wondering when! I am here for you! You attack the good in this world, little one. We should bring balance together. Ugh.
At the foot of the grand statue was an anvil. Itself not a beautiful thing, but the base upon which beautiful things are born. And here were Hephaestus's tongs, which he plunged deep into scorching fires and frigid waters.
Plunged!
Only in those extremes could his creations be perfected. What?
You know, that's all. All the play he's getting. Because you know all of him. In the looks department. Because he's...
Are you finished?
Yes. Yep.
Finally, after much climbing, Fenyx reached Hephaestus's hammer.
Sorry! I'll stop!
Ah, the Forge Lands. The many workshops. The soaring peaks.
Are we on a guided tour here or something?
The ancient creations, wasted by Typhon's endless appetite for destruction.
Oh.
Someone down there was alive. Working. And seemingly happy.
Definitely not Hephaestus, then. That whining, sniveling coward never smiled a day in his life.
Have you listened to a word of this story? Things have changed.
Needs a little sunshine.
What are you doing?
Huh. Nothing. Nothing. Well, something. One thing.
I'm Fenyx. Who... What are you?
Dialogue. With me. Okay. We plan for this, don't freak. Who or what are any of us? We are what we do. I am arting, so I'm some kind of artist. Clearly, you are appreciating that art, so are an appreciator.
I'm a warrior. Or the sibling of a warrior. I'm warrior adjacent. Anyway, I'm here to stop Typhon.
Hmm. That checks out. You didn't look like much of an appreciator, no offense. But maybe this will change your mind.
A little box?
What? No, that is so my last phase. I signed it, though. You can keep it. No need to thank me.
I can't read this. You're a sculptor. I scaled your statue. You're Hephaestus, right? I'm so excited to meet you in person.
So, not that one. Fine. That's fine. Totally fine. But I have others.
To find your essence so we can defeat Typhon. Do you know where it is? No?
Confusion or rapture? Are you rapt?
This is just my face. How can you art at a time like this? Don't you know what's happening?
I think it's safe to say I do not.
Typhon? Everyone turned to stone? Gods all lost their essences? Evil monsters everywhere! End of the world! You really have no memory whatsoever?
Who needs the past when you can shape the future?
It'd be easier to shape the future with hands. Typhon stole them, I assume. Ripped them from your limbs? Tortured you endlessly. Something?
You really need to sit down with this Typhon guy. Talk it out. And no, my hands had enough of making art and scurried off together.
They can't have gone far. And who knows? Maybe if I get them back, they'll jog your memory. Save the applause for when I come back.
I could sculpt a tree with happy little tree friends. Do trees have friends?
Huh. This place looks like a battlefield. Or a graveyard. Handy.
Challenge me, Fame, and you shall be reduced to nothing.
We're going to eat Typhon like sad octopus!
I hope we get to are about to after die. This
shall cheat death.
I hear he's incredible.
Woo! Ha!
Ha!
There, near the gates and above the wreckage left in Typhon's wake, Fenyx spied what looked like a working automaton hand.
Yoink!
You know what they say? You can't spell paint without pain.
Forgetful automaton thing!
Artist works.
That's what I said. Look, I found your hands.
Industrious, Typhon-obsessed appreciator. You are full of surprises.
Hold still while I just... No! What was that?
No idea.
Still no memory, huh?
No. Well, maybe one. I work there.
A pearl in rough seas. Forge fires lit. A wise child convinced. A feather's weight of wit. Forge fires lit. Forge fires lit! Your forge is part of the prophecy! It must be the answer! You have to remember! The forge! The glowy blessing thingy that just came out of your hands! You are a god!
Flattery! I think you're great too.
No, an actual god! Back home, I told dozens of different stories about you. Myths, legends, gods, monsters, all of it! You're Hephaestus, the god of the forge! Remember?
I always thought I was a Jerry. Paul, maybe.
This isn't working. We have to jog your memory to find your essence. I need you to think. How do we start the forge?
Ventilation shafts channel air to four coal-burning furnaces. A network of canals must feed frigid waters through water wheels to the summit. Central combustion is controlled through two mechanisms in the forge core.
How do you know that?
Know what?
Forget it. Unblock vents, start fires, spin water wheels, then something about mechanisms. Stay here and make sure those hands don't go anywhere.
Instead of painting on a pot that has fruit in it, what if the painting is a pot with fruit in it?
Never before had a mortal laid their eyes upon something so grand, so gargantuan, so spectacularly crafted, so...
Over it! Just get a room already!
Well, I would if I could. Hephaestus's forge is that incredible.
None of those furnaces are burning. There must be something around here I could use to light them. Flame is hot as Helios.
He's not all that.
One more to go.
I will make you perfect. You will suffer, but it will be worth it.
All the flames are lit, but the forge hasn't restarted. Maybe I have to do something else. What's that blocking the forge's ventilation?
Fenyx cleared the first vent, but realized there must be another. Suddenly came flowing through the gate, like the forge itself was taking a breath.
So that's what that smell was. I honestly thought it was me.
Huh.
As Fenyx explored Hephaestus' ancient forge, she discovered its most important component, the water wheels.
Why does a forge need water?
Look, Zeus, I do futures. That's my thing, not forges. Unblocking the first of the water wheels caused it to lurch back to life. With the water gushing like torrents of rain, Fenyx was one step closer to freeing the forge from Typhon's grip. Little did Fenyx know, however, that the worst was yet to come.
Vents cleared, water flowing, furnaces burning. Time to go to the heart of the forge.
Fenyx laid eyes upon the blade once used by Perseus to slay Medusa. A blade so perfect, it was as much a challenge to forge it as it was for Perseus to wield it.
Oh, that's where that went. I used it to trim my chest hair.
Here, adorned with immaculate detail, was the shield Hephaestus crafted for the mighty Achilles.
For a forge. And that one could be a hammer. Hephaestus has the mightiest hammer ever crafted. That glyph, I think it represents this forge. And that one matches the statue outside. These are some kind of clue.
For my next piece, I'm seeing snow, but trapped in a globe.
Hephaestus, you're here!
It's like the forge was calling me. I couldn't ignore it.
About that. I cleared the vents, started the fires, and got the water wheels moving. Even unlocked some strange glyphs inside, but nothing happened.
Well, I was talking to my hands, as one does, and they said they're the key to restarting it. They have to touch things.
Now we're talking.
Zeus.
This place is ancient. They say you built this entire forge yourself.
Me? But it's so grim, so dirty, and that lighting.
We don't know what that does!
Shame your labors have been wasted on mediocrity. The disfigured god's past is a cesspool. His future, the cleansing fires of the forge! Turn away! Leave him to burn in its flame! Potential is outweighed by your foolishness! A pity I have to balance the scales!
Festos! Come out! You're okay.
What is this? Such pain in these markings. Sorrow? Suffering?
Real art. I'd say you were trying to leave us a message.
Me? How mixed media?
I think past you left a clue to recover your memory. Something Typhon couldn't decipher. Can you read any of it?
It's incomplete.
Hephaestus, you genius! It is missing a piece! Now, where did I put it? This isn't your signature, Hephaestus! It's the rest of the puzzle! Hammer, a forge's fire, the statue, and this box. Do you know what this is?
Of course, he did not know what it was, but in their possession was Pandora's box.
You dare to open this again? Chaining you to this rock was your justice for giving fire to mortals. Pandora's box was the mortals' justice.
So you forced your son Hephaestus to forge a box capable of unleashing every conceivable evil upon them? That's justice?
Hephaestus was happy to oblige. He knew what he was doing.
He did what he was ordered to do after you tortured him for his entire existence.
Don't you talk about my son!
Pandora acted with innocent curiosity by opening that box. You acted with vile contempt.
I gave them a warning, and look what happened. Mortals ravaged and defiled their world and each other. Clearly, the warning was not enough. It's finished now. They are stone. And Pandora's box was the beginning of the end.
So, first, we need a hammer.
Check.
Where did you... Never mind. I think past you is telling us we need to imbue that hammer with the power of the forge's fire. Then break through here.
That is so me.
If I'm reading this right, your essence is underneath. But that's not all. I told you what this is.
That'll be a box.
No. Well, yes. But also, it used to contain every kind of suffering. Enough suffering to fill the world. And you suffered, Hephaestus. A lot. Cast from Mount Olympus. Rejected. Alone. No matter how generous you were, no matter how hard-working, every god rejected you just because you were different. This box is the final clue. I think Typhon stole your suffering, and that's why you lost your memories.
So, to get my memories, to get my talent back...
will mean feeling the pain that's been locked away.
Go!
despite the extreme heat, Fenyx carried on undeterred, plunging the hammer of Hephaestus into the heart of the fire.
Prometheus, this is pushing it. No human could dream of holding that hammer.
Or holding your lightning? And yet, absorbing the power of the flames, the hammer came alive. And with it, Fenyx released the second of Hephaestus's blessings. With the hammer revived, and Hephaestus's suffering trapped below, all Fenyx had to do now was jump.
It's hard. Maybe.
Fenyx felt a chill in the air of the vault that was more than cold.
Sorry, that's my new cologne. It's by Porius, the North Wind.
I know, he's my cousin.
Oh, and he didn't even hook you up. Ice cold.
The air moves so strangely. I wonder if I could use that to help me get around. Looks like I can change the wind's direction.
Whoop! Mother, no! I can change! I'll be the son you want!
Just as you had packaged the torments of the world to so kindly give to humanity, Fenyx would trap Hephaestus's torments inside Pandora's box. His suffering, his tortured inspirations.
My kid's an artist. What can I say?
From that flame, the malice inflicted upon Hephaestus emerged.
Malice? What malice? Hephaestus had it easy.
Well, you threw him off Mount Olympus. His mother rejected him. The gods mocked him. No one invited him to dinner. Or if they did, they'd change plans at the last minute.
I'm busy, Prometheus. It happens.
Take my past! Set me free! Please let me come home. I'll do anything. Anything.
I will always be the disfigured god.
Despair emerged from the illuminated flame, and Fenyx was quick to return it to Pandora's box.
Look at Hephaestus. Someone like him, he should have just settled. He's the one who held Hera hostage, demanding Aphrodite's hand. I knew she would never touch him. She would be safe and unavailable. It was perfect, so I agreed. He brought despair on himself.
Its heft was heavy. As was Phoenix's worry. By retrieving these dark memories and returning them to Hephaestus, was she dooming him to misery? The question haunted her as she continued.
Forget your quest. Walk unburdened. Let Typhon take us. Undo the cruelty we have wreaked. I will live in the flame, and it will not consume me. How could you? I trusted you.